Let us take this plastic container. We will make it heavy by adding some sand. We will tie this container with a rubber band to the pencil. Let us place this on these water bottles. Ruler helps to find out the length of stretched rubber band. What will happen if I hang it by itself? Rubber band is stretched as weight of the container is pulling it down. What if we add more sand to the container? It will be stretched more. If we push the container by hand upward, length of the rubber band decreases. At one point, it becomes loose. Now let us put this heavy plastic container inside this plastic bottle. What will happen if I pour water in the container? Will it remain in the same position or will loosen up a bit? Let us pour some water. As water level rises, it brings the plastic container up with it. This is similar to our action of pushing the container with our hand. Instead of our hand, water is pushing the plastic container upward. This force exerted by water on the object is called buoyant force. What will happen if we use salt water instead of plain water? Rubber band is now less stretched, as density of salt water is more than that of normal water. Buoyant force exerted on the block is more. This is the reason why it is easier to swim in sea water than fresh water. If I take this aluminium foil and place it inside water, what will happen? It goes down. But if I take the same sheet and make a boat from it, will it sink? Though the weight of the sheet and the boat formed from it has not changed, the shape has changed. Due to change in shape, immersed portion of the boat displaces water equal to its weight. When an object floats, the buoyant force balances the force of gravity. When it sinks, gravity wins. Have you ever tried to push a plastic ball under water? What have you experienced? It's difficult to push the ball down. It comes up very quickly. This is because large upward force exerted by water on the ball. The upward force exerted on any object which is immersed in water or any other fluid is called buoyant force. Imagine that instead of air, this ball is now filled with water. What will happen if we put this ball again in water? It will be in equilibrium when we immerse it in water. Will the buoyant force same if we use oil instead of water? Do give it a try. Challenge. These two balls are of the same size. One is filled with water and other is empty. I mean, it has air. When I completely immerse these two balls in water, will the buoyant force acting on these balls be same? Summary. We discussed about buoyant force and reason why some objects float and others sink.